everyone, welcome to Bible Party Online. It is Wednesday evening and it is good to be with you, kind of, for Bible Party Online. And I hope your week has started off well. It's the midpoint of the week, so let's pause and, you know, just learn a bit about the Bible and party a little bit, have some fun. And I want to begin with some Name That Tune. I have songs this week that are oldies. So these are oldies, and they're some of my favorite oldies. Actually, they're not just oldies, they're Motown songs. Motown, music that came out of Detroit during the 60s and 70s. So these are Motown songs. Let's see if you can name the tune of this first Motown song.
I need love, love to ease my mind. I need to find someone to call mine. But mama said you can't hurry love, no, you just got to wait. She said love don't come easy, it's a game of give and take. You can't hurry love, no, you just got to wait.
Okay, that song was You Can't Hurry Love. You Can't Hurry Love is the name of that tune. But this second one is a good song as well. Another Motown song. Let's see. The name of the song is in the song. So let's see if you can pick it up. That song was called My Guy. My Guy is the name of that song. And this final one is one of the most famous Motown songs out there. Here we go. That, my friends, was My Girl by The Temptations. So we had My Guy and then My Girl. So My Girl by The Temptations was that last song. Thank you for playing with me once again, Name That Tune. We are going to get started with an opening prayer, and I'm going to have Laura Beth open us in prayer. God. Thank you. For this day. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Laura Beth, for praying for us to get us started. Well, I shared on Sunday that I remember when I was 8 years old and my family moved from Minneapolis to Houston. But that wasn't the only time we moved. We actually moved quite a bit when I was growing up. So let me really quickly, I'm going to tell you the places I've lived. So I was born in Durham, North Carolina. Then we moved to Sartell, Minnesota, then to Minneapolis, Minnesota, then to Stafford, Texas, here in Houston, then to Flossmoor, Illinois, then Fresno, Texas, again here in Houston, Then I lived in Arkansas and Chicago and Kansas City and finally moved back here. And I still have quite a few years, hopefully. So I'm saying I'm not that old. So that's quite a few moves within not that too many years. I've moved a lot. And what I've learned from moving is that it's exciting, but it's also sad. Because you're leaving what you know, you're leaving the people that you know, and you're moving on to something new. Now, we've been talking about how God has good news for us. We talked about all the parts of the good news, that God forgives us, and he makes us righteous, and he adopts us as his children. But my question is, all of those things are true. Don't get me wrong. However, do we have to go it alone in this life? Even with those good things that we can remember and we can put our faith in God about. But Jesus, if you remember, he died and he rose again and then he ascended into heaven. He left. He moved away. Do we have to go through life without Jesus, without God with us, just on our own strength? Or is God still with us somehow? Well, today, the part of the good news that we're going to discuss is that God is always with us through the Holy Spirit. I might have moved around quite a bit, but God does not move away from us. He is always with us through the Holy Spirit. So in our passage today in John 14, Jesus is getting ready to go to the cross and then to rise again and then to ascend into heaven. He's going to leave his disciples. He's been hanging out with these disciples. He's best friends with Peter and James and John and Philip and Matthew and all of these people. And he's been hanging out with them for 3 years, but he is about to leave them. So how does he prepare them for his leaving? He's about to go. What does he say? Does he say goodbye? I'll see you guys later? No, he doesn't say that. This is what he says in John 14. I'm going to read a couple verses here to get us started. It says, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Before long, the world will not see me anymore. But you who believe in me will see me. Okay, a couple things there. Jesus is saying goodbye. He's supposed to be saying goodbye. Normally, when you say goodbye to somebody, you don't say, well, you're not going to miss me. You're still going to see me. Right? He's not saying a proper goodbye. He's saying that I'm not leaving you, really. I'm leaving you physically. Yeah. Jesus left us physically. He's not physically here on earth anymore. But he says, I am not going to abandon you. I am going to stay with you. I will not leave you as orphans. And then he says this, if you love me, you will obey what I command. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever. The Spirit of Truth. You know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. So Jesus is saying the Holy Spirit will be with you and will be in you. And that's how I will be with you, through the Holy Spirit. And then the last verse I'll read today is verse 26. He says, but the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you. So y'all, the disciples, they're realizing that Jesus is about to leave them. And they are probably distressed and anxious and worried. Jesus, what are we going to do without you? You've been teaching us and leading us these last 3 years, and we've just been doing what you tell us to do. Now you're just going to leave us, Jesus? And Jesus says, don't worry. I'm not really leaving you. My Holy Spirit will be with you and will be in you. Keep your faith in me, obey me, love me, and you have my Holy Spirit who will be with you. It'll be just like I am with you, just not physically. God is with us always through the Holy Spirit. God is always with us through the Holy Spirit. One of my least favorite days of the year that I talked about on Sunday was December 26th, but really, for me, after I thought about it for a little bit, my really least favorite day of the year is January 11th. That's because I love Thanksgiving, so, you know, the end of the year is exciting, and Christmas, obviously, is very exciting, and New Year's is still exciting. So even though after Christmas finishes, it's kind of sad, but you still have New Year's, and then my birthday is January 10th, and so there's all these exciting things back to back to back to back in that little space of time. But January 10th happens, my birthday happens, and then January 11th. And now it's just January. And the Christmas and New Year's and my birthday are all past, and I have to wait basically a whole nother year for all of them. And so January 11th is my least favorite day of the year because all those days have left me. However, God does not leave us. We do not have to get to the point ever where we're waiting a whole nother year to see God again. Right? God is always with us through his Holy Spirit. It's like having Christmas and New Year's and a birthday every day with God, because God is always with us through the Holy Spirit. All right, y'all, enough of that. Let's write a card. I actually haven't decided who we could write a card to. I haven't written it yet, so I'm gonna have to write it just as we go. How about we write to Russell Westbrook? Russell Westbrook is a player for the Houston Rockets, and they lost yesterday, so we need to write to encourage him because they need to beat the Lakers, right? They're in the playoffs, second round right now. So let's write to Russell Westbrook, who's a good player, and I will have to write this later, but let me see. Let's think of what we could write. We could write something like this. Dear Mr. Westbrook, thank you for playing for the Rockets. We love to watch you and we are cheering for you. Go Rockets! At the Brookwood community this week, we learned that God is always with us through the Holy Spirit. And we always try and share the gospel at the end, so we could say, remember that Jesus died on the cross for our sins, and he rose again. Your friends, the citizens of the Brookwood community. That sound okay? I'll have to write that later. But very good. Hopefully that's encouraging. So, that is our card for the week. Let's have a little bit of time to let loose a little bit and dance and praise God through our dance. And let's do that.
Even when my light burns low, I could never lose my hope. I've been down this road before. Now I know which way to go. You can try to drag me down, but I'll be living in the clouds. Everybody has their doubts, but you can't stop now. You just gotta.
I want it like I need to breathe, yeah. Make it clear like I need to see. Woo. As a kid, mama told me sky's the limit till you hit it. Like King Griffey, jump inches out of there. Out the park, hit and run, that's my drive.
vibe, it's a vibe, been that way all my life, yeah. I shut it down when I shine with the crew, yeah, I ride with the crew, gave my life to the crew, testify. Walk on water like the Son of Man, understand, I'll never drown. Take a hit, never quit, might be down but never out. There are days that I fail, and the train's off the rail. Through the pain we prevail, tell them you just gotta live.
Even when my life burns low, I could never lose my hope. I've been down this road before, now I know which way to go. You can try to drag me down, but I'll be living in the clouds. Everybody has their doubts, but you can't stop now. You just gotta
till there's nothing left, lean on. We need you like there's no one else. Ain't nobody out here more like you. And with you that broke the mold, and ain't no more like you. That's for sure. I can't drop out like the top down on the coupe. Tell them watch out when I walk, I make a move. Sunday morning with my hands up, like they got the handcuffs. Searching for some answers since mama passed cancer. And my sister left Seattle with a one-way ticket home. Hope she holdin' Chase and teaching him to speak some more. Gotta keep it going. Yeah, that's all he told me. Tell him you can make it when you know the one and only.
Burning right beyond the fire. You were born to win, yeah, you're a fighter. Don't let your light just fade away.
Everybody, very good, very good. Thank you again for joining me for Bible Party Online, and I am going to leave you with my friend Grant, who is going to close us in prayer.
Go ahead.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, then, and the kingdom come, that it be done as in heaven. And give us our daily weather, to give us the trespasses, to give us the gifts, and lead us up to temptation, and be delivered from evil, and that is the kingdom, and power, glory, forever, ever. Psalms 23.
Amen.